Hi guys. This evening I'm going to show you VG3 boat color. It's an old colorway. I got it at quite a good price. Hence I decided to buy it. This is the usual Nike the new Nike packaging which I'm not in favor of it, but I will tell you why. Because usually it comes crushed, but because I buy a few gloves, so the thing comes the gloves were out of the box, and the box was packed nicely and neatly. Hence I have a perfect box. Usually don't be surprised if you buy Nike gloves, usually the gloves, the box will come smashed. Due to the fact that most couriers, they just throw it around, things like that. So shit happen, yeah. So usually most would receive torn boxes, but I got a perfect box. I don't know whether I want to keep it or not, but hey, anything goes. Okay, I got my Nike VG3. Let's see what's inside it. Okay, usual thing. Okay, inside the plastic packaging wrap. Yep. Let's throw the box aside. Okay, I'm gonna tell you why I don't really like Nike packaging. Okay, but anyway, okay, these are the gloves. Okay, it's Vogue, and I think it's orange. Okay, it's in a VG3 cut. Okay, it's a patented cut. Okay, why? Because of the Nike designed this way back in I think 2000. Two, when they came out with the first series of VG3, worn by Jens Lehmann, was the first few to wear VG3, Nike VG3 cut. Okay, why this cut? Okay, this cut. Okay, what makes it special is the overwrap on the fingers, which they patented. Okay, most gloves with overwrap on the pinky and the pointer will usually no other gloves company that does this. That means they can do this, but in another way lah, maybe reverse way or maybe no sharp cuts on it, things like that. There's another way to it lah, but that's what I know and that's what I've learned. Okay, this is a size 10. Okay, I bought mine. Okay, using the contact plus latex. Okay, it's a significant improvement compared to the different generations of contact gloves. This one is usually after one or two pre-wash, it's ready to go. It's really really tacky, really really tacky. Okay, I love the new. Especially the design with this the gloves with this, I find it the latex is a bit different. Okay, and then there's a seam here that they cut V, and a V here and a V. I don't know, there's stitching on the your hands, so it allows movement, so that, it's easier to bend compared to other gloves that doesn't have it. Okay, it's easier to bend. Okay, okay, I'm gonna put this on. Okay, yep, typical Nike VG3. Ah, yes, it's a nice glove to put on. Actually, I really like VG3 a lot, okay? A lot. Because why? For me, I think it's almost the perfect glove. Due to the fact that it's light. I like light gloves. Back end is not too minimum, but it's not too heavy. I like the wrap overs here. It makes my fingers feel more secure than usual. Okay, all right, this is the Velcro enclosure. Okay, okay, they use elastics. Okay, black in color. This is 3-point, 3-point, we call it 3-point arrest system, right? Okay, because they have three Velcro, one, two and three. This is the signature of it. Okay, one of the signatures of Nike VG3s, other than the wrap pinky and wrap pointer Okay, the two middle fingers. This is the retail version. Okay, this is not the promo version. The promo version, you can choose whether it's negative stitch. They call it the reverse stitch. Nike call it reverse stitch. So many terms. Got headache sometimes. So I got the reverse stitch here to make your two finger, your middle finger, and your other finger to be like tighter, more snug fitting. Okay, there are drawbacks to VG3. Okay, one thing, the first drawback is due to the overlapping. Okay, overlapping of this finger. This finger is alright. Okay, it's actually wider, so it feels like a roll finger on the pointer and pinky. Okay, the not good part is due to the overlap. Okay, the not good part is when you are stopping a hard shot. Okay, the fingers try it rotates. Okay, so it can be painful at times. It rotates. Okay, your glove rotates. Okay, it rotates seriously. Okay, so it's a bit weird on the pinky, but then again, if you are used to VG3 like me, like I am, okay, many people got injured wearing these gloves, but I'm used to it. So I usually tape my pinky, so I don't think it's a big problem for me. So those who like injured their pinky before, that kind of stuff. So best, my advice to you is tape up your pinky before using any VG3. Okay, so when you tape up, it will be like it will hold up for you, rather than rotating together, so it causes most fingers to like bend out of shape. Yeah, I myself have one, so I try to like every time I wear VG3, I'll tape it up, especially my pinky. Here it's not too bad. If it's rotate, it's still manageable. Okay, but for pinky is usually not the strongest finger. The thumb is the strongest thumb pointer because you pick things up. But not your pinky. Okay, it's not useless, but it's not the strongest. Usually, it's not the strongest finger on the bone because there's no more support to it, and it's shorter. So it's like always road. It gets go most goalkeeper like doing fingertip, low tip, and then using your pinky, some like maybe hit on the ground on impact, and you open your gloves and you have a scary movie. So it happened to me. It happened to me. It happened to all the goalkeepers, I guess. Most goalkeepers are. If you haven't had it, that means you're very lucky. Okay. So this is the Nike VG3. Okay. The backhand is using foam. I think I'm not too sure what foam they're using, but I think it's basic latex. It's quite soft. Okay. Air holes on it. Okay. To have breathability, and they are using like mesh system. Okay, here is also mesh, so it breathes and it's light. They made the glove light. That's a key feature of VG3. So if you guys is skeptical about VG3, I don't think there shouldn't be any skepticism. It should be like I embrace this glove a lot, and I really love VG3 a lot. I really do. It's not the cheapest glove around, but compare. Many people ask me the comparison between Adidas to this. Which one do I prefer? Of course, it's personal preference. Compare Adidas and Nike. Of course, I choose Nike because I've been wearing Nike since I was young. So I'm more like loyalist. But I collect Adidas glove. That's the irony of it. other than that, I think it's quite a perfect glove, but it's not cheap. It doesn't come cheap. So when they launch the model, usually it's around £80, like maybe 150 Singapore dollars. 150 Singapore dollars. But there's never one VG3 that I didn't like. Okay, my favorite gloves are the VG3 Team Krul. Maybe one day I'll bring it out and show you guys why it's the best. But nevertheless, I still love my VG3s. I have quite a 6 VG3s that I kept. But yeah, this is one of the better gloves due to the lightness. Okay, and the pump is decent, definitely decent. Wet weather decent, dry weather decent. So maybe if it's too dry, maybe you just wet your pump slightly, or maybe rub your sweat off your face. I'm not a big fan of spitting on my glove. I think it's hygiene, personal hygiene. So usually I don't spit. I would just wipe the sweat using gloves so that it remain damp. Okay. So this is my take on the Nike VG3 Volt. See you guys.